Hi, I'm Richard Kaupla-Burning, and this is my personal project video about why East African runners are always dominant in distance running events.
It has come to my attention that in all long distance running events, this includes races from 5 kilometers all the way up to the marathon, African runners are always dominant and earn spots on the podium. More specifically, East Africans. Kenyan and Ethiopian athletes are almost always dominant in these events. Is this a coincidence? I think not.
You may think that the world's best distance runners come from a highly populated country such as the United States, and that they train in some sort of high-tech sporting facility surrounded by the world's best scientists. However, you may be surprised to find out that this is not exactly the case. Let's find out where the world's best distance runners actually come from.
These are the world's best long distance runners.
These guys are doing sets of 2K, 1K times 5 at the pace of 550 for 2K and 250 for 1K. So fast, slow, fast, slow.
They are training in Kenya in a small village named Iten, nicknamed the Home of Champions, because this is where most of the world's best distance runners are born and raised. Let's take a look at the fastest marathon times ever ran. In the top 100 fastest times ever, there are only two athletes who are not of Kenyan or Ethiopian origin. The top 149 fastest times have all been run by African runners. Not to mention, no runner of non-African origin has ever broken the 2-hour 5-minute barrier in the marathon, while African runners have done this over 100 times. Let's find out why this is. To find out more about this topic, I had to consult with someone who has first-hand experience with African running. This is Roman Fosti.
From the tile, and I'm hating the slack. Couple man slide around, let the hate in the gaff. Please stop talking that trash, cause the vibes in the front all the way to the back.
Roman is one of Estonia's fastest distance runners, with a personal best in the marathon of 2 hours and 12 minutes. He has been training in Kenya for almost 7 years now. He has first-hand experience with living and training in Kenya, alongside some of the best distance runners of all time. I interviewed Roman to get a better understanding of this topic. Why do you train in Kenya? What benefits does training in Kenya give you?
Esiteks, ma treenin seal kindlasti sellepärast, et seal on kõrge mäestiku efekt. Ma olen sellest aru saanud, et selleks, et ikkagi siin heal tasemel Euroopas joosta, ma pean kasutama seda kõrgemäestiku efekti. Ehk siis, kui ma tulen merepinnale, mul on kõrgem hemoglobiin, punaste vereliibed arv on ka suurem. See toodab rohkem hapniku lihastesse. Ja mul on kopsud töötanud mäestikus teistmoodi, kui siia, kui ma tulen merepinnale, siis mu hingamine on teissugune. Et see on selline nagu lubatud doping. Ja see on üks asi. Teiseks muidugi treeningpartnerid. Eestis paraku mul pole kellegi koos treeni teha. Seal on mul võimalik valida erinevaid treeninggruppe. Ja mis keenialased ise ütlevad, et nende edu võti ongi gruppides treening. See, et sa ei ole mugavast soonis.
Kui ma siin ikkagi olen üksinda treeninga, siis ei ole ikkagi päris see tunne, aga kui ma seal vaata lähen jooksuma, mul on selline, et ma näen kõrval jookseid. See juba tekitab sellest koha, et näed, keegi valab veel nagu higi ja verd, et saada vaata tugevamaks.
Et kui mul Eestis on siin, ütleme, sõpradega kohtumisi või ühest ja teise kolmandasse kohta mineks, siis seal ma olen nagu ühes paigas, magan trennide vahel, õigel ajal lähen magama, režiim on nagu paigas, aga siin Eestis paraku see režiim kaob ikkagi ära, eriti suures linnas elades. Aga ma olen ise näinud, et ikkagi ma ei taastu siin nagu nii hästi kui seal keskkonnas olles.
There are a variety of factors that contribute to the dominance of East African runners. These factors can mainly be distributed into three different groups. These are environmental variables, social variables, and psychological variables. First, start with environmental variables. In the case of the East African runner, it is widely believed that birth and living at altitude produces great athletes, despite the great range in athletic productivity observed between areas of similar altitude. If altitude were the only factor involved, then all African countries with high altitude, as well as countries such as Nepal, Peru, and Mexico, should be producing many world-class athletes. Let's hear what Roman has to say about why no other high-altitude country produces nearly as many world-class long-distance runners.
Et seal pole seda sisemist konkurentsi, et võib-olla seal pole sellist kultuuri, et tegeleda selle jooksmisega.
However, the environment in East African countries such as Kenya and Ethiopia is practically ideal for running. Let's use Kenya as an example. Over 75% of the country's 43 million people inhabit rural areas. In these rural areas, there is no public transport and poverty is very high. People cannot afford cars. This means that kids have to walk or run to school. Kids in these regions often run to school because it is faster. Sometimes they even race their friends to or from school. Another environmental factor that contributes towards the success of East African runners is nutrition. Nutrition is highly important for runners. Runners must be able to adequately fuel their body in order to be able to give the most into every training session. Having a low body fat percentage, and in general a low body weight, is important towards running economy and running efficiency. In these rural areas, food often comes directly from farms, and it is not processed, which means it is healthier and contains less harmful substances. This makes it a lot easier to keep your body weight low and stay healthy.
Kolmandaks, keskkond on selline, mis soodustab ka õiget taastumist ja toitumist. Et seal on tervislik toitumine, süüakse juurvilju, maisijahust tehtud ugali, mis on süsivesikust rikas ja vitamiini rikas. Ja siis tuhat kideri on selline oad ja maisist tehtud toit, mis on siis valgu kui süsivesiku rikas. Anatoomilis poolt ma arvan, ongi see, et nad on lapsepõlvest saati toitunud tervislikult ja nende keha ongi selline slim, et nad ei ole palju lihasööd, siis lihased ei ole nii suured, et nad on kerged.
The terrain in Kenya and Ethiopia is also often very hilly, which eliminates the need for doing strengthening exercises in running training, since constantly running uphill strengthens your calves and other muscles in the leg.
Vaheldu maastik muidugi, et Tallinnas, kui sa siin siledel maal jooksed, siis tegelikult sa pead jõutreeningut lisaks tegema, aga seal jooksed ju iga kord üles alla.
This is Eliud Kipchoge. He is considered the greatest distance runner of all time. He was the first man to break the 2-hour barrier in the marathon, and he currently holds the marathon world record.
The pace car is gone, we've lost the laser.
He's getting quicker.
It's now all down to Eliud. Go! Eliud Kipchoge, let's keep an eye on the clock. Into the final 20 seconds, Eliud Kipchoge.
Whoa!
He's got his shoulder, 140! 140, the unofficial time.
There's his wife.
Eliud Kipchoge storms into the history books in Vienna. 159.40.
Kipchoge comes from the Kalenjin tribe in Kenya. This tribe produces most of the world's best distance runners. Kipchoge used to run just over 3 kilometers to school and back every single day as a child. That's almost 30 kilometers of running a week, starting from the age of about 7. In some schools in rural areas in Kenya and Ethiopia, they do not provide lunch at school. This means that in the morning, the student will have to run to school. When lunch break starts, the student will run back home from school to eat lunch, and then back to school again. When school is over, the student runs back home. This can increase the weekly volume of running to well over 60 kilometers a week. Running this much at such a young age builds up the person's so-called aerobic engine, which lays a foundation for a career of endurance running. Now, let's take a look at the social variables. In Kenya and Ethiopia, the two countries which have produced the most world-class distance runners, motivation among athletes, no matter their level, is extremely high. In Kenya, 36% of the population lives below the international poverty line. This means that poverty is very high. For these poor people, a career in running is a proven way to escape poverty. Runners from these countries who perform well get recognized by coaches and get contracts, which can lead to them traveling across the world competing in big city marathons. Athletes in these countries dream big. They know that so many people from their country, or even their village, have succeeded and become a world-class runner. So they think, I can do that too.
Ma tean, minu arvates see sisemine motivatsioon on neil nii tugev, et sealt vaesusest nii-öelda välja saada. Ja teiseks see mõtte viis, et keegi nagu ei karda seal välja öelda sellised eesmärke. Kui ma küsin, et noh, mis aega sa tahad joosta, siis ütlevadki, et ma tahan maailma rekordi joosta. Et nad on näinud, kuidas nende nii-öelda õed vennad on kiirelt jooksnud. Sisemine konkurents on väga tugev ja ikkagi jooksed on enamasti pärit sellistest vaesematest peredest ja selleks, et sellest vaesust välja saada, see on nagu nende jaoks selline suur sisemine motivatsioon panna ennast pingutama, et saada paremale elujärjele.
Regardless of physical attributes, the tougher athlete often prevails, and the difference between success and failure is often more easily and perhaps more appropriately attributed to factors such as psychology. Psychologically, performance can be considered to be a function of the interaction between a person and the environment. Running is an extremely physically and mentally challenging sport. Some even say running is more mentally challenging than physically. When running at the peak of your limits, every second holding that pace is a struggle. Therefore, motivation and willpower are absolutely critical to success in running. This is Joshua Cheptegei on his way to breaking the 10,000 meter world record in Monaco.
I was talking to his coach, Adi Ruta, and he was saying that Joshua has a massive appetite for pain. He says, I don't really need to equip him with any mental tools to try and cope with the pain. He's just born with a gift to take punishment, and that's what he's going to need to be able to do tonight.
Bergschlosser disclosed in the 1970s that of all the Kenyan tribes, the Kalenjin had the highest achievement orientation, while Peter Malman more recently found that Kalenjin athletes had extreme self-discipline and focus in sport. Both factors are considered to be important in the success of athletes. This extreme self-discipline is because the runner is highly motivated. He or she often dreams of making a career out of running and finally escaping poverty.
With what I have achieved now, I am fully motivated. That's why I love the sport, and what drives me every day is the love of sport.
The deeper meaning of the quote, "No human is limited," is that it goes across all the professions, not sport alone. If you work very hard, you can achieve what you want. You can do wonders without any limitation.
Doing this project got me thinking, could a runner of non-African origin ever be competitive for top spots with a runner who was born and raised in Africa?
Based on the research and analysis I have done, I have made the conclusion that yes, theoretically it would be possible for a non-African athlete to be on the same level as a runner who has been born and raised in East Africa. The best example of this is a Swiss elite long-distance runner named Julian Wanders.
Praegu on jällegi üks Šveitsi jooksja Julian Wanders, kes läks noorelt sinna elama ja praegu on minu naaber seal. Ja Julianil on ka see, et ta on kerge kaaluga. Šveitsis arvatavasti iga mägedes seal vaata elanud ja ka selline Keenia jooksja keha moodi vaata. Et ma arvan, kui me leiame siit Euroopast kaota sellise keha, kui me paneksime neid treenima ja võib ka tulla häid jooksid. Isegi Keeni jooksid ja sellised treenid nagu tema.
Julian is one of the world's greatest, if not the greatest distance runner of non-African origin. he holds the European record in both half marathon and 10-kilometer road race. Julian lives and trains in the Global Sports Communication Camp in Kaptagat, Kenya, alongside some of the world's best runners, including multiple world record holders, such as Eliud Kipchoge and Joshua Cheptegei. He is a member of the NN running team, and he has dedicated his life to running. Julian is so successful because he has adopted the Kenyan training lifestyle, and he is extremely focused and motivated.
Iten is like a running environment, like I would say it's perfect. It's growing a lot because of tourism and of course running. But still a very peaceful place. It's crazy, like you will wake up at 6 and see like groups of 50, 100 people going for training, and this is something you don't see everywhere. I mean, there is maybe a few places like this. The first time I came in 2014, I saw it was for me the best place to come and train. Not only for the altitude, but also for the groups who are really like here. It's the strongest runner in the world with Ethiopia. It's really a good atmosphere to progress and help each other. So there is a lot of reason, but the main reason is really the atmosphere, and it's really special.
In conclusion, there are a variety of factors that make East African runners so good at the sport. Training at altitude, having a suitable training environment which provides them with the right nutrition and training partners, starting training at a young age, having internal motivation, and having a very strong mindset are all very important factors that contribute towards their success. That is all. I hope that this video has helped you understand the competitiveness of the running world and East African running. Thank you very much for watching my video.